Some scriptures the Lord put in my heart just to encourage you. First, and so there may be, it may not be like one talk, it may be just scriptures, and I'm explaining different scriptures, it may not be one continuous subject. Don't mind, I'm just giving you what the Holy Spirit has put in my heart. Amen. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 22. Yashayana Pustaka. 60:22. Adhyaya, Ipaterdane Vachana, 60:22. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in its time. Amen. Chikkavaninda ondu kulavaguvudu, alpaninda balavada janangavaguvudu. Amen. Chikkavaninda ondu kulavaguvudu, alpaninda balavada janangavaguvudu. Amen. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. Praise God. This is what God said. Say, God said. The Lord is saying, from a little one, shall become a thousand. Chikkavaninda ondu kulavaguvudu, and a small one a strong nation. Alpaninda balavada janangavaguvudu. Amen. There are many times we look at ourselves and we think, I am small, I am too weak, I don't have strength. Nanage shakti illa, nanage balavilla. ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ಚಿಕ್ಕವನು ಎಂಬ ಒಂದು ಯೋಚನೆ ಬರಬಹುದು. ಆದರೆ ಅಂಥ ಜನರ ಒಂದಿಗೆ ದೇವರು ಮಾತಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ಹೇಳುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಚಿಕ್ಕವನಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಕುಲವಾಗುವುದು, ಅಲ್ಪನಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಜನಾಂಗ ಉಂಟಾಗುವುದು. ಆಮೆನ್. ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಒನ್, ದೋ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್, ಲಿಸನ್ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲಿ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಗಾಡ್. ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಹೌ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಯು ಆರ್ or how weak you are, Jesus loves you. Say, Jesus loves me. Jesus loves you. No matter how small you are or how weak you are, Jesus loves you and he wants to use you. Devarige nimmanu avara rajyadalli upayoga madabeku emba aa ondu uddeshavide, aa plan ide avaralli, avarige nimma bagge. Though you are small, though I am small, God will use me. And this is the word God wants to tell someone here. From a little one, there will be a thousand. And from a small one, there will be a nation. Amen. Shall we read it out together, all together? A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one, a strong nation. Not just a nation, a strong nation. Balavada janangavaguvudu, alpaninda. Amen. And so listen, this is what God wants to tell us this morning. It's not just a word I searched and found, a nice word, let me say. This is the Holy Spirit wanting to tell some of you this morning. Alpaninda ondu jananga untaguvudu, balavada jananga. From a small one, there can be a strong nation. It doesn't matter today how anointed you are, or whether you are even anointed or not. If you can offer yourself into the hands of God, a little one can become a thousand. The smallest one among you, the weakest one among you, can bring a thousand to Jesus. Are you listening? You can be a blessing even if you are the smallest in this church, even if you are the smallest believer on this planet. From you, God can bring even thousand souls and more into his kingdom. Hallelujah. Give a clap of praise for Jesus. A little one shall be a thousand. It's not your 1 rupee becoming 1,000, let's understand that God's grace can make you mighty. ದೇವರ ಶಕ್ತಿಯು ದೇವರ ಪರಾಕ್ರಮವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಳಿದು ಬಂದಾಗ ನೀವು ಅದ್ಭುತ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ದೇವರಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಆಮೆನ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಮೈಟಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ನೀವು ಒಬ್ಬರಿರಬಹುದು, ಆದರೆ ನೀವು ಒಬ್ಬರಿಂದ ಸಾವಿರಾರು ಜನರು ದೇವರ ಬಳಿಗೆ ಬರಬಹುದು. ಅವರ ಪರಾಕ್ರಮದಿಂದ, ಅವರ ಶಕ್ತಿ ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುವ ಕಾರಣದಿಂದ ನೀವು ಅವರಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಸಾವಿರಾರು ಜನರನ್ನು ಅವರ ರಾಜ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಕರೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಬರಬಹುದು. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Give another clap of praise for Jesus. Amen. You may be a new believer, you may be a weak believer, but the Bible says from a little one will come a thousand. And so listen, nobody here, none of you here can say this is all I know. Nanige ishte gottu, nanige en jaasti en gottilla. We cannot say that. God has already said from a little one and from a small one there can even be a strong nation. Amen. Amen. Doesn't matter how weak you are, but this is God's word for us over the church and over your life, that even the smallest of you can become a strong nation and a mighty nation because of the power of the Holy Spirit working in you. Amen. Give a clap of praise for Jesus. Amen. And so your eyes have to be set. God, you should take this verse and say, God, I thank you. You can make me a mighty nation. You can make me into 1,000. Hallelujah. Don't just sit with your things and your problems and your worries. Lift up your eyes and look at the kingdom of God. If you know Jesus Christ has died for you on the cross, if you know he has shed his blood for you, if you just believe him, this verse is for you. Amen. It's not for somebody else. You, doesn't matter how old you are or how young you are. It doesn't say a little one below the age of 50. Any Bible, any version? Latest English version? A little one below 50? Or a little one above 25? No. Doesn't matter. The age doesn't matter. Say, the age doesn't matter. It's God's word that matters. You should live like this. God, a little one, if a little one can be 1,000, when I come to heaven, I should bring at least 1,000 people with me. Minimum 1,000. Say minimum 1,000. Say minimum 1,000. Say minimum 1,000. Do you get it? That's what the Bible says. Hallelujah. If a little one can become 1,000, it talks about strength. I'm applying it to our spiritual area and talking about souls. But it's in every area. That means in Christ, even the weakest one, the smallest one, has that ability. For every area of your life, you have ability in Christ Jesus. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Are you excited? Or is not for you? You're not a little one or a small one. You're very big. We'll come to that also. Praise God. Hallelujah. And so you should fix your eyes on things like this. Lord, and Isaiah chapter 60, the first verse starts by saying, arise and shine, for your light has come. Amen. Arise and shine, for your light has come. Eddu prakashisu. Yelu prakashisu, ninage belaku bantu. Yehovana tejasu ninna mele udayiside. God's glory is shining. Say, God's glory is on me. Say it loudly. Say, God's glory is on me. Don't say, I'm small, I'm weak. What will the small, what will the little one do? A little one will become 1,000, and the small one will become a strong nation. Say, this word is for me. Amen. We are not just called to do ordinary things, we are called to do extraordinary things in Christ Jesus. Amen. Say, I will do great things for Jesus. Say, I will do great things for Jesus. Say, my eyes are opening. Say, I can do great things for Jesus. And you don't have to always go out somewhere. You start praying and seeking God. Spend time in His presence. He will start filling you with His glory and start giving you a vision. He will start showing you what to do. And you will be, with just your prayer, you will be able to bring some people. In prayer, God will show you what you can do, what you cannot do, and what you should do, and what you should not do. ನೀವು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಾ ಇರುವ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಪ್ರೇ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಾ ಇರುವಾಗ ಇರುವ ಹಾಗೆ ದೇವರು ನಿಮಗೆ ದರ್ಶನ ಕೊಡುತ್ತಾರೆ. ದೇವರಿಗೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಪವಿತ್ರಾತ್ಮರು ನಿಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡಿ ನೀವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಎಂಬುದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ ಹೇಳಿಕೊಟ್ಟು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮೂಲಕ ಆ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡುವವರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಯು. ಆಮೆನ್. ಬಟ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ಹೇ, ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ರೀಡ್ ದಟ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್. ಐಸಾಯಾ 60:22. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in its time. Read it again all together. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. And so with that, as God declares that word to you, you have lost the right to say, I'm too small, I'm too weak, I don't know much. No excuses will work. The word of God says, a small one shall become a strong nation. And so you should confess over yourself and say, I can do great things for Jesus. Whether things work out well in my life or not, I will serve Jesus. ನನ್ನ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಷ್ಟಗಳಿರಬಹುದು, ನೋವಿರಬಹುದು, ಏನೇ ಕಷ್ಟಗಳಿರಬಹುದು, ಆದರೂ ನಾನು ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಇದ್ದರೂ ಸಹ ನಾನು ಯೇಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತರನ್ನು ಸೇವಿಸುತ್ತೇನೆ, ಅವರ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೇನೆ ಎಂಬ ಒಂದು ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ಇರಬೇಕು ನಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್. ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸರ್ವ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸರ್ವ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ಲಿಸನ್ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲಿ, when you fix your eyes on Him and His purpose like that, many of your problems and confusions and difficulties will leave automatically. Amen. You may not be able to do much right now, but fix in your heart, fix a goal. Nimma jeevanadalli aa guri irabeku. ನಾನು ಯೇಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತರ ಸೇವೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೇನೆ. ನನ್ನ ಎದುರಾಗಿ, ನನ್ನ ವಿರುದ್ಧವಾಗಿ ಏನೇ ಬಂದರೂ ನಾನು ಯೇಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತರ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೇನೆ. ದಟ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಜೀಸಸ್, ದ ಡೆವಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಲೀವ್ ಯು. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡೆವಲ್. ಆಮೆನ್. ನೀವು ದೇವರ ರಾಜ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಆ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ಮಾಡುವಾಗ, ಆ ಒಂದು ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡಾಗ, ಸಾತಾನನು ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಓಡಿ ಹೋಗುವನು. ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀವ್ ಯು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ಆಮೆನ್. ಸೇ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ಸೇ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ಸೇ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಜೀಸಸ್. ಆಮೆನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಸ್, Isaiah 40:31. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Amen. Let's read it in Kannada. Yehovananu nirikshisuvavaro hosa balavannu honduvaru. Hosa balavannu honduvaru. Avaru haddugalante rekkegalannu chaachikondu yeruvaru. Amen. Avaru odi daniyaru nadidu balararu. Amen. Those who wait on the Lord, that means those who depend upon Him. That word wait, it's not waiting for Him to do something, Most of the places in the Bible, when the word wait comes, it means to pray or to be with the Lord. Those who wait upon the Lord means those who are with the Lord, those who spend time with the Lord, those who sit with the Lord, those who wait upon the Lord, those who depend upon the Lord. Say, depend upon the Lord. The Bible says those who depend upon Jesus, they will renew their strength. Avaru hosa balavannu padidukolluvaru. Those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength. Amen. How many of you are here still? If you spend time with Jesus, if you wait upon Him, you see, sometimes, listen, look here, and listen carefully. Sometimes you're tired, you're weak, you say, I don't have time to pray, I don't have time to do this, I don't have time to do that, I cannot read the Bible, I cannot pray, I don't find time. That is the reason you are not going up like the eagle. Are you listening? Do you want to go up and fly up like an eagle? Haddugalante haralu nimage ishtavideya? ಹಾರಬೇಕಾದರೆ ನನಗೆ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ನನಗೆ ಸಮಯ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವತ್ತೂ ಹಾರಲ್ಲ. ಹಾರಬೇಕಾದರೆ, ಹದ್ದುಗಳಂತೆ ಹಾರಬೇಕಾದರೆ ನಾವು ಕರ್ತನನ್ನು ನಿರೀಕ್ಷಿಸಿ ಅವರೊಂದಿಗಿದ್ದು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವರಿಂದ ಅವರ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆದುಕೊಂಡರೆ ನಾವು ಹದ್ದುಗಳಂತೆ ಹಾರಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಫ್ಲೈ ಹೈ, ಡು ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರೈಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಫ್? Yes, I don't think most of you want, or you didn't hear me. It's a good question I asked. Do you want to fly up? Do you want to fly up in the sky? Do you want to fly up in your life? Do you want to rise above your circumstances? The eagle is the only bird that flies above the storm. All the other birds, they know to fly, but they fly below the storm. Birugali beesidare haddu matra adara mele harutte, bere ella pakshigalu ee birugaliya kelage harutte. They are afraid, they stay low, but the eagle knows to go above the storm. Are you listening? How many of you are here? If you want to fly above the storms of life, storms will be there. Whether you are a sparrow, neevu chikka hakki agiddaru illa hadd agiddaru, birugali ellara viruddhavagiyu barutte. A storm comes against everybody's life. Whether you are an eagle or a sparrow, the storm is a reality. But if you want to fly above the storm like an eagle, it is not more education. Are you listening? I have to study more so I'll get more. No, you study because you have to study. It is not increasing your skill. Get your skill because you have to get your skill. But if you want to really fly above the storm, learn to be with Jesus. Every day, learn to spend time with Jesus. Give Him time. Sit with Jesus. Because my God said, those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, and they shall soar with wings like eagles. Amen. Hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. And give a clap of praise. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. It's not my word. It's not an imagination. It's not just a saying. God said, if you wait upon Him, you will soar. You will renew your strength. You will be new. You will have new strength. And you will be able to soar above the storms. Amen. Shout hallelujah. You have sickness. You want to go above the sickness? Sit with Jesus. You have a problem in your life which is unsolvable. You don't know what to do. Sit with Jesus first. Spend time. Wait upon Him. Jesus, speak to me. tell me what I should do. And wait till you hear his voice, either in your heart or through the word. Wait till you get a response. Do this. Go this way, my child. Do this. When God speaks, you will always go above the storm. Amen. But you have to wait. If you say, God, I have 5 minutes, talk to me quickly. That's why the Bible uses the word wait upon the Lord. That's why the Bible uses the word wait for prayer. When Jesus was in the Garden of Gethsemane and his disciples were sleeping, Jesus asked them, could you not watch with me or wait with me for an hour? It's important for Jesus. It is important. Say, it's important for Jesus that you be with him. He loves you. He wants time with you. And that's why you need to wait. Wait with him. Don't say, I will pray for 10 minutes every day. If that's so, that's the time you have spent. But come back later and spend some more time, because you need to wait upon him. What do you need to do in your future? You don't know. You're confused. Don't study books how to have a great future. He must have written it after failing many times. Till 75 he failed, 76th year something worked, he wrote the book. That you don't know. Or don't check Google. Future options. You can check, let it all be there. But first go to God, who made you, who formed you, who loves you. Spend time with him. Because God said, those who wait upon the Lord will renew their strength. You may have become weak because of the struggles of life, but if you wait upon him, your strength will become new. Nimage hosa balavu siguvudu kartana kadeyinda. His strength will be new. Hosa bala, hosa shakti. New strength you will receive because you love Jesus and you want to live for him and you want to soar higher for his glory. See, all of whatever I say, please underline the foundational thing is if you live for his glory. If you're not planning to live for his glory, then many things I tell you is not applicable, because the whole Bible is for his glory. So Isaiah 40 is not just for me to fly like an eagle and tell the other bird, see, I'm an eagle, you're a bird, you're a small. Many people are doing that in the Christian walk. They're flying high to tell others, see, now I can fly, I can fly. That's not the reason. It's for the glory of God. Say, glory of God. Rise for Jesus. Say, rise for Jesus. When God shows you what you have to do, he gets the glory and honor. It's not just about your future. He gets the honor. He gets the glory. Amen. How many of you are here still? Yes. Praise God. See, he will renew my strength. And the Bible says in the same verse, they will run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. That means if you spend time with Jesus, if you wait on him, if you depend on him, no matter how much you run in this life, you will never say, I'm so tired of life. And if you say that, immediately you will know, if I'm tired, that means I'm not spending time with Jesus. You will go back and be with Jesus. Because those who are with Jesus, they will run and not be weary. They will walk and walk and walk and walk and walk through this life, and they will not faint or fall, because Jesus, God, is their strength. Amen. Amen. Give a clap of praise for Jesus. Amen. That's the second scripture for you. Say, I receive it. Amen. The third one, Ephesians chapter 3. Ephesians chapter 3 and verse 20. Now to him who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us. To him who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಯ ಸಾಧಿಸುವ ತನ್ನ ಈ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ನಾವು ಬೇಡುವುದಕ್ಕಿಂತಲೂ ಯೋಚಿಸುವುದಕ್ಕಿಂತಲೂ ಅತ್ಯಧಿಕವಾದದನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲು ಶಕ್ತನಾದ ದೇವರಿಗೆ ಸಭೆಯಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತ ಯೇಸುವಿನಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ತಲತಲಾಂತರಕ್ಕೂ ಯುಗ ಯುಗಾಂತರಕ್ಕೂ ಮಹಿಮೆಯಾಗಲಿ. ಆಮೆನ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎವರ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಬಿ ಲೆಟ್ ಗ್ಲೋರಿ ಬಿ ಟು ದಟ್ ಗಾಡ್. ಆಮೆನ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಫೋಕಸ್ ಆನ್, ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟು make it clear to all of us again, he is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. Amen. Beduvudakkintalu yochisuvudakkintalu atyadhikavagi madalu ballannu nama Yesu Kristu. He is able to do. Say he is able. Say he is able. Say God is able. He is able to do exceedingly abundantly much more than we ask or think. Now beduvudakkintalu yochane maduvudakkintalu adhikavagi madaballanu namma devaru. He is able to do that much, and when he is able to do that much, still we try to do things with our own strength. Namma shaktiyalli navu eshtannu sadhisalu navu prayatnisutteve. ಎಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಶಕ್ತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ. ದೇವರ ವಾಕ್ಯವಿದೆ ನಮಗೆ, ನಾವು ಬೇಡುವುದಕ್ಕಿಂತಲೂ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡುವುದಕ್ಕಿಂತಲೂ ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡುವುದಕ್ಕಿಂತಲೂ ಅಧಿಕವಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಲು ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಯೇಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತರಿಗೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೂಲಕವಾಗಿ. ವೆನ್ ದಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಆರ್ ವರೀಡ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಯುವರ್ ವರೀಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಲೀವ್. ಆರ್ ಯು ಲಿಸ್ನಿಂಗ್? Why? Because my God is able to do. Not just, he is not some a God who just talks. He is able to do. He is a God who does things in action. Our God did not just say, I love you. He showed it in action. He sent his son Jesus to die for us on the cross. He did it in action. He is a God who does things. And so he just doesn't say, I will do things. I will do. There are so many people in our lives who talk like that. What do you want? I will do. What do you want? I will do. And when you want, they will be missing. Am I right? Or you will be missing. Somehow you will miss it. But our God, the Bible says, is able to do more than we ask or think. But this next portion says, or the more important part there is, according to the power that works in us. Nammali karya sadhisuva tanna ee shaktiya prakara. Nammali karya sadhisuva tanna ee shaktiya prakara. Nammali karya sadhisuva ee shakti. This power, how does God do this first portion here? How does this work? How does he do exceedingly, abundantly, above what we ask or think? He doesn't do it from heaven. He does it by the power that is working in us. By the power that is working in you. Say, in me. Are you here? Yes, how many of you are here? Not from some other place, not from Australia, not from Egypt, not even from heaven. Because what God has to do, he has done. He is not working from heaven. He has already sent his Holy Spirit in you. Say, he is in me. That's a truth that you should take hold of. And I pray that before you leave this place today, your eyes will be open fully to this truth, that he is going to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. Not from heaven, but according to the power that is working inside us. Say, he lives inside me. Say, I have power within me. if you go to a government office and something is not working, you should know this is going to change by the power that is working inside me. Are you listening? Yes. You have a problem, you have a mountain before you. You are not saying, God, please move this mountain, do something. No, don't cry. He is going to do exceedingly abundant. He will do, but according to the power that is already in you. And that's the Holy Spirit. This mountain before you will move because of the power He has already put inside you. Amen. Give a clap of praise for Jesus. Are you listening? Say, there is power working inside me. And that's why don't allow any evil power to work inside you. Anger, frustration, worry, jealousy, fear, competitiveness, all these ugly, dirty things, don't allow it to function. When that you allow that to function, you will never be able to release this real power that God has given you. Amen. You should give a clap of praise for that also. Don't allow the devil to confuse you and stop you into thinking, I will be angry and I will be like this and I will live my life the way I want. I will go the way I want. I will plan my life. Don't allow the devil to lead you that way and then expect this power to work. When you give yourself to Jesus and say, I reject. We read in 1 Peter chapter 2 a few weeks back. Keeping aside all hypocrisy, malice, and desiring the pure milk of God's word. Amen. Just desiring God's word. Keep aside everything evil. And when you do that, you will see this power that works in you. And if you find it difficult to deal with that evil, how do you deal with the same power? But you should have the intention. You should have the desire. I don't want this evil inside me. I don't want this horrible nature inside me. I need to focus on Jesus and on the kingdom. And you depend on this power within you. Say, the power within me. It's not just the mind power. It's not just the power of positive thinking. It's the power of the Holy Spirit of God. Amen. Say, it's the Holy Spirit of God. Say, it's the Holy Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Say, He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that I ask or even think of, according to the power that is at work within me. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. A scripture along with that, Colossians chapter 1 verse 27. To them God will to make known what are the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Christ in you, the hope of glory. I ministered on this a few months back, a few messages on this, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. You can read it in Kannada. Mahimeya nirishige adharanagiruva Kristanu nimmallidanembude. Amen. Amen. Christ in me. Say, Christ in me. The hope of glory. See, listen. It is not Christ in heaven, the hope of glory. Are you here? Yes. It's not Christ in heaven, the hope of glory. No. Christ in... When God has made His home in you, why should you look somewhere else? You always know that God... That Jesus Christ is with you. That's your hope of glory. And so you're not afraid. You're not weak. The Bible says with God, all things are possible. Amen. Yes? Are you happy? I have to ask you in between. With God, all things are possible. That God is in you. You are with God. If you are aware and if you realize God is with you always. And the Bible says with God all things are possible. It doesn't mean you should go and pray now and try something. You realize that this God is in me. And with God, I am with God. God is with me. And with God all things are possible. Whatever you face, whatever challenges, and your desire to win souls, and that should be your primary goal. Take your eyes away from everything else. All other things God will handle for you. Pray and pray and pray. God, use me. Lord, use me to bring people into your kingdom. Even for that, it is with God all things are possible. With God, I can win souls. With God, I can change my life. With God, I can change somebody else's life. With God, I can have a healing. With God, I can heal somebody else. With God, I can give a new life for somebody else in Jesus' name. With God, all things are possible. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. So Christ in you, the hope of glory. And according to that power that is working in you, He is able to do more than you ask or think. And so you should relax, you should rest. God's word says, He is able to do. He is able to do. Say, He is able to do. And trust Him and start praying. Don't pray out of fear. ಭಯದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡಬಾರದು, ವಿಶ್ವಾಸದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆಮೆನ್. ಇದು ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿದೆಯಾ, ಆಗುತ್ತಾ, ಆಗಲ್ವಾ ಎಂಬ ಆ ಥರ ವಿಶ್ವಾಸ ಇಟ್ಟು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡಬಾರದು. ಯೇಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತರು ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆಯು, ನಾನು ಯೇಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತರ ನಾಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡುವುದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಡುತ್ತಾನೆ ಎಂಬ ವಿಶ್ವಾಸದಿಂದ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆಮೆನ್. ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೇ ವಿತ್ ಫೇತ್. ಸೇ, ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೇ ವಿತ್ ಫೇತ್. The last few set of scriptures, it's one set from John chapter 10. John chapter 10, verse 9 first. John 10, verse 9. I am the door. I am the door. Jesus is the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. Amen. Such a beautiful truth. Jesus is the door. Say, Jesus is the door. Say, Jesus is the door. No matter what I preach and what I don't preach, no matter what message it is, never take your eyes off Jesus. The foundation is always Jesus Christ and His glory. Amen. Yesu Christana mahimeyu, Yesu Christaru atane agidane namma foundation. What is foundation? Adipaya. He is our foundation. Jesus Christ. Say, Jesus Christ. And Jesus is saying it so beautifully. He's saying, I am the door. Say, Jesus is the door. Nane bagilagidene. I am the door. And he who enters by me will be saved. If you enter through Jesus, if you go through Jesus, if you get into Jesus, you will be saved. Jesus is our message. Jesus is our life. Jesus is the gospel. Jesus is grace. Jesus is hope. Jesus is eternal life. Jesus is healing. Jesus is deliverance. Jesus is our everything. Amen. 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 Jesus, if you enter through Jesus, Jesus said, I am the door. Don't trust somebody else. Don't go somewhere else. Don't trust something else. I am the door. You enter through me. And if you enter through me, you will be saved. Saved out of everything. Saved out of hell. Saved out of sin. Saved out of your bondage. Saved out of your problems. Saved out of everything. You enter through Jesus. Amen. Jesus said, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved. He will go in and out and find pasture. Praise God. ಯಾವನಾದರೂ ಒಳಗೆ ಪ್ರವೇಶಿಸಿದರೆ ನನ್ನ ಮುಖಾಂತರವಾಗಿ ಅವನು ಸುರಕ್ಷಿತನಾಗಿದ್ದು ಒಳಗೆ ಹೋಗುವನು, ಹೊರಗೆ ಬರುವನು ಮತ್ತು ಮೇವನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವನು. Such a beautiful verse. Jesus is saying, if anyone enters by me, he will go in, he will come out, and he will always find pasture. Are you listening? Our trust is not in something. It's not in the, not even in the gifts of God. Not even in the blessings He gives us. Our trust is in Jesus Christ, the Lord God of our lives. Our trust is in Him. When you hold on to Jesus and you stay in Him and enter through Him, Jesus said, you will go in, you will go out, but you will always find pasture. You will always find what you need for your life. You will always find answers for your life when Jesus is the one you enter into and you walk with Him. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Say, Jesus is the door. Every morning when you get up, go through Jesus. Enter that door. Because if you enter through Jesus into that day when you enter through Jesus, you will go into your house, you will go out of your house, you will go into your office, come out of your office, you will go everywhere. As you go, you will find His peace and you will find His pasture. He will find His, you will find His food inside you. Amen. Give a clap of praise for Jesus. Amen. Verse 11. I am the good shepherd. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives His life for the sheep. Tanna pranavannu koduthane. He gives His life for us. That's what Jesus has done for us. Verse 27 to 30. Chapter 10, 27 to 30. My sheep hear my voice and I know them and they follow me. His sheep should follow Him. If you are a sheep, if you are His sheep, don't follow somebody else, follow Jesus Christ. And I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. Neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. Shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. Neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. Amen. Jesus said, if you, my sheep, hear my voice. Nanna dvani keluvavaragirtare, nanna kurigalu, they will hear my voice and they will follow me. Say, they will follow me. You will follow Jesus. And when you follow Jesus, Jesus said, I will give them eternal life. They will never perish. You will never perish if you trust in Jesus. And if you follow Jesus, you will never, 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 never perish. You will never perish. Neevu endu yavattu nashavaguvudilla Yesu Kristaranu himbalisidare. If you go behind Him, you will never perish. You will always rise up in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Give a clap of praise for Jesus. Amen. You will never perish. Neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. You're in the hands of Jesus. Say, I'm in the hands of Jesus. Say, I will not perish. Say, I will not perish. Say, I'm in the hands of Jesus. Say, I follow Jesus. Say, I listen to His voice. Say, He is my good shepherd. And He has given His life for me. He's the door. He is also my good shepherd. He has given His life. He just didn't say, come follow me, and then say, go do what you want and die yourself. He gave His life for me. He is a good shepherd. Say, He is my good shepherd. And this is the Lord. And this is the God we follow. The good shepherd who gave His life for us. And He is telling you, if you follow Him, you will never perish. Say, I will never perish. Say loudly, I will never perish. Say loudly, I will never perish. I will never perish. Amen. Because I follow Jesus Christ. I follow Jesus Christ. So don't take your eyes off Him. You may want to become a big nation. You may want to soar like the eagle. You may want more than what you ask or even think of. All that is fine. But never forget Jesus Christ is the one who takes you up like the eagle. Jesus Christ working in you is the one who makes the little one a thousand. Jesus Christ working in you is the one who gives you more than you ask or even think of. It's Jesus Christ. Just lift your hands up. Lift your hands up. Close your eyes and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's stand up and pray. Let's stand up and pray all together.